Not For Human Consumption episode 9.
Number 9.
It's never going to get old. We only get to do that once. Unless we do an episode 99, then we'll do it all over again.
Oh, yeah, twice, though. Yeah, 9999.
We're not doing that many episodes. There's not that many weeks in my life.
It's when not we get to 99, not
you're not
going to
break it that long.
We will get to 99.
Alan might die before then.
I know. I'm going to have another catastrophic episode.
We'll have to wake him up from a coma.
Yeah. Just don't. Hey, if I'm in a coma, rule is, don't look at my dick.
Yeah, me and Alan have a...
Why do you keep showing it to me when you're fucking awake?
Because I'm awake and I can choose. But when I'm asleep...
He works in the medical field. We have a fucking thing between us. If he's at a hospital I have to go to, don't look at my dick.
Can't look at his dick. It's a rule.
Alan, here's a rule for us.
Enjoy his dick.
If we're in a situation where you're the medical professional and I'm the patient... I'd prefer it if you looked at my dick.
It's going to put me in the shock. Yeah. That's what starts playing as soon as it's whipped out.
It's hard like steel of T-34 tank in Siberian winter.
The second the zipper goes down, you get met with bush, tip, and miss.
Shut the fuck up, you cunt!
That's how you just end every clip.
Oh, shit. So this week, it's Matt and Dave in the room, but Dylan's our Utah correspondent. He's out of
hanging
town.
Hanging out in Utah. He's in a hotel room, sitting by the window, looking at another building.
Via satellite.
Via satellite, dude. We make this sound way more high-tech than it is.
Yeah.
Free hotel internet that's doing somehow.
It's actually working great.
Wait a second. You sat down to do this episode without actually purchasing an internet connection? Wow.
Taking a chance.
We purchased it the other day, and it was exactly the same as the regular. Like it was no difference. Not worth
$4 a day. Dave.
So Utah.
Yeah, hanging out in Utah.
Me too, Utah.
Working a whole bunch. We decided to go out last night, which. We were sad about the beers because they're only 3.2% alcohol.
Everything in Utah is 3.2%.
But they raised it because it used to be, 2.8 or 2.6 or something.
Maybe it's always been 3.2. I don't know.
No, it has not. No. I have family from there. It's fucked.
It's just water.
It was water.
We found a sweet little bar last night, though.
What's the name of the
bar? Right across from our hotel. It was the Summit Bar and Grill.
What a generic-ass fucking name.
It was the most happening spot in Utah, I think.
Shit's popping.
They're bumping some 90s rap. It said live music on Fridays and Saturdays. It's just a DJ.
Did you guys watch the videos?
That's live music. There's so many white people on the dance floor, though. Dude, so many videos of just
awkward.
Tons of white people dancing awkwardly.
The awkward jig.
If you watch one of the videos he sent us while he's corresponding, it was some dude middle-aged white guy just getting down to fucking Lil Jon.
Lil Jon.
It was so good.
I didn't watch the video yet. We need to post it.
Yeah, we will. It was so good.
This shit will go out.
I took six videos of that guy.
I heard there was a fight or something. Didn't you say something about the fight?
There was two girls got in a fight, and they didn't get kicked out, but we got kicked out.
What? What the fuck did you do?
Well, you can't apparently vape in Utah in a bar, or that's like fucking murder.
Oh shit.
My friend Max vaped, and I think they warned him once, and he's like, whatever. But then all of a sudden later on in the night, security came over and you're done, you get the fuck out of here.
Oh,
and I'm like, what happened?
People shouldn't vape anywhere.
You can't fucking do that in here. And he's like, well, I'm gonna go pay my tab. And they fucking
cloud.
Yeah, they watched him pay his tab to make sure he didn't vape again, I guess. I don't know what they were doing.
You make sure you give them money.
They watched to make sure he didn't vape while he was paying? Is he that addicted?
I don't know what they were doing. They were just standing there watching him. This wasn't a big bar. It's not like he's going to run somewhere else in the bar and hide from him.
There's one bartender and two security.
Yeah, it was a small place.
And a bunch of Mormons getting down to Little John.
Oh,
weird.
So him being... Him being the smart ass that he is, he hit it again on his way out the door and blew a big cloud in there. And
Oh, shit, Max. I like the style.
They were not happy about that. There's this big black security guard that had a shirt that said, "I would cuddle you so hard," that we spoke to earlier in the night, that we were referring to as Big Bear because we call Max Little Bear.
Little Bear?
Little Bear so Pocket Bear. Wolf?
Little Bear? Wait. Where did Little Bear come from? Tell me.
I don't remember, honestly. I don't call him that often. I just call him Sexy Max. But
Sexy Max?
Fair enough.
I'm
Sexy
just kidding,
Max and Pocket Wolf?
I just made that up.
Dylan is called Pocket Wolf for our listeners.
Pocket Wolf. And when he wears the shirt, it's fucking absolutely sublime. You people.
Sublime.
God. He's a Pocket Wolf who wears a shirt covered in wolves, including the pocket. Including the pocket.
God damn it.
So yeah, as we're leaving, we're walking through the parking lot towards the sidewalk to walk back to the hotel, and that security guard's going, Hey, Little Bear, get back here.
Little Bear and Pocket Wolf.
Dude, you can't be super pissed and be like, Little Bear, get over here.
Get
you know,
over
like,
Little Bear, you son of a bitch.
There's no way to yell that accurately. No. Like,
Little Bear.
But that dude came over and fucking grabbed him by the shirt.
He
grabbed him by the shirt and got in his face and was screaming at him, telling him, "You don't disrespect my bar and you don't fucking do that. And I need a yes sir from you." He demanded a yes sir. No, he was just a security guy with a name tag.
Give me a yes.
He was a cuddler
sir.
Though.
Give me a yes sir. I'll give you a fucking punch to the face.
God damn it.
Yeah, like. It was pretty unreal because those chicks that were fighting like totally got to stay.
Well, your violence good and anything else is bad.
Because
well,
people shouldn't vape anywhere.
Vaping contains drugs and drugs are not allowed in the Mormon society.
Yeah.
But alcohol and fighting?
Dave vaped in my face hard right now.
We were the most attractive people in that bar though. I'm gonna go ahead and say it.
So you were
the table. Well, our
was
table
Max, like,
was
way more attractive than you because you're fucking nasty, ugly little dude.
Hey, I appreciate his looks.
In Phoenix,
you're staring at me right now.
In Phoenix, he's a chairman on the Unfuckables board. But in Utah, he is one
he's
of the
fuckers.
He's a
Utah 10?
Yeah. One of the fuckers.
Utah
he's
10.
One of those dudes. He's one of those dudes you look at the bar and you say, this guy fucks.
I'm not a Utah 10. There's some very, very gorgeous females in Utah. I'm a Utah 8 for sure.
Okay.
Kentucky 10, definitely.
Kentucky 10.
Fuck.
But we got hit on, which is usually girls aren't the ones that come up to the guys at the bar and hit on them. But in Utah, it's like all the girls were looking for it, apparently.
Oh, Mormon dudes are scared.
All of us being taken men, we did not partake in the hitting on. They came up and the one girl was like, "Oh, what are you guys getting into tonight?" And she noticed our friend Justin had a wedding band. She's like, "Oh, you have a wedding band, but how about the rest of you guys?" And he said, "Well, our other friend Stendel, he's like, well, he's married, but these two aren't." So I had to grab Max's hand and say, "Not yet, anyway," just to get them to leave.
It's adorable.
And they seemed disappointed.
It's super adorable.
It was.
I was all about all of it.
Is he good? Does Max have a thigh gap?
I don't know, man. He's in the. You want me to grab him? He's in the next room.
No.
Oh, no.
No.
By the thigh gap.
Grab him by the thigh gap.
Sleeping naked on the bed.
He just reaches over, taps him on the thigh. He's like, "It's your turn to be on the podcast, Little Bear.
Little Bear.
Oh, no.
Yeah. So, yeah, we got kicked out of a bar in Utah.
Shit.
For
man.
Vaping.
For vaping. Pretty,
for vaping.
It's like, you guys are drinking Pepsi? That's got caffeine.
Get the hell out of my
bar. Get out of my bar.
I can't believe you're disrespecting my establishment.
I've gotten thrown out of bars in Utah.
Have you?
Yeah, I have family there, so I'd go to visit. Just a little seven-day trip around
the
holidays.
What the fuck is this swill? This isn't beer.
Yeah.
Pack and be sober still.
Yeah, it was no good
there.
You
drank all of my Amstel Light. Get out.
Amstel Light?
No, I would only drink the hard alcohol because that's the one not touched.
Right,
not
right.
touched by the filthy hands of the Mormons.
$7 gets you a beer and a shot of whiskey.
Yeah, see?
Really, I bought a giant beer for $5, man.
Because
it's like, it has to be giant beer because the... then it's like the same alcohol content as a regular
I also
beer.
Had a Shock Top from Arizona that I brought with me, and I drank that on the way to the bar.
That. You could have sold like, that. You probably could have sold that on Backpage for a lot of money.
He could be downtown Salt Lake by the temples.
Yeah.
With a fucking trench coat and just fucking open his trench coat like a fucking jihadi bomb set.
Dude, I can bring some Four Peaks and change their life.
It's all real beer fucking quantities.
Get that.
Dude, imagine.
No, imagine that. Fuck that. Get that New Belgian 9% Imperial IPA, the Voodoo Ranger. Oh, dude, one of those. It drops somebody in Utah.
Standing in a dark alley and he's all, hey, kids.
Yeah, hey.
You want some Four Peaks?
It's 14 regular beers for them.
Right? Yeah. Well, because it's like 4 or 5 for us, honestly.
God damn it.
I haven't had many alcoholic drinks in the last 7 months, so I did get pretty toasty last night.
Oh.
That's a good...
Wait. It's so you guys got thrown out of a bar... the first time you've been drunk in a few months for vaping.
That's fucking telling, yeah. Dave. Thanks for fucking bringing that up. Fucking Dylan hasn't drank in a year. He had a couple on New Year's, and then he apparently took another break until he got thrown out of a
I've
bar.
I've had like one
until
or two.
Until he got thrown out of a bar.
I haven't been drunk since May of last.
Hey,
this is the first time I've been like, oh, I feel this one.
Do you have a problem, Dylan?
I was going to say, maybe you have a problem.
Yeah.
You ever thought about that?
When you go to order a drink and the bartender's like,
shut the fuck up, you cunt!
Shut it.
God damn it.
I thought I ordered a drink. I just apparently
I wanted to take some time off.
Well, so then how are you feeling though? You don't foresee this being an issue again, do you?
There was never an issue to begin with.
Yeah.
That'll teach you to vape in Utah at a bar.
I mean, there's definitely a vaping issue in the world, but I don't have that.
Did you hashtag vape life on your way out? All tough.
Hashtag vape life. As they're probably playing fucking Montel Jordan as we walked out the door.
Oh, man. This is how we do it.
Oh, my God. Is there music so far behind there?
Dude, well, it was all 90s rap.
It was all 90s
rap. It was all, but it wasn't all. I take that back. They were playing some new stuff, but it was like listening to rap radio stations. You know how like every hour on the hour they play the same fucking four songs. They kept playing that Cardi B song and a couple other songs that are like super popular right now. Every fucking 45 minutes.
The Mormon Church. Check this out. This is real. The Mormon Church has Salt Lake locked down so hard that to get new music in, the military flies a C-130 over Salt Lake and they airdrop surplus CDs.
And everybody down on the ground's like,
for a second, I was like, whoa, this is like good info. Like, whoa,
really?
This is the inside track here, you guys. For like 2 seconds, I was like, wait a second.
Everybody on the ground's like, you know, you could email me, right? Wait.
I can't wait till you guys show me that Ugandan meme. Like,
eat the poo-poo.
Exactly. Like, you guys keep dropping this shit on me. I have no idea what
they
the
do. This
is
thing
up.
Called Eno feasting.
Oh, dude. Dave doesn't know.
Nope.
Where'd it go?
Soon.
No. Do you know that Ugandah,
yeah.
This preacher does not like gay people.
No.
We at our podcast, we accept all. Well, this guy.
Yeah, I mean, when Alan comes out of the closet, I'll embrace him.
Are you going to be like this?
I've taken time to do a little research. To know what homosexuals do in the privacy of their bedroom. One of the things they do is called anal leaking. Where a man's anus is leaked like this. By the other person, like ice cream, and then
even
poo-poo comes out. The other poo-poo's out, and then they eat the poo-poo.
They eat the poo-poo.
The other one they do is they have a sex practice called fisting, where they insert their hand into the other man's hand, and it goes on into the anus all the way. And it is so painful, they have to take drugs, but they enjoy it. This is what they do. Number one. You can see a man here having sucked the other person's rectum.
Yeah, he's in a church.
And
he's
showing a slideshow to the congregation.
Uh-huh.
And this one is eating
man.
The poo-poo all over the place.
All over the place.
Tell me, when you have a low...
Shut the fuck up, you cunt!
Every time you end a fucking clip. Every time. I love it. It's perfect.
Yep. So good. I like it.
I am the laptop guy now.
I am the laptop guy.
I
am the queen. I don't even know what that means yet.
So, all right.
We did discover that Utah is the most beautiful place to look at while being the shittiest place to be at.
Well, that's strange.
I concur. I don't ever want to be there again.
It's fucking terrible. Like, sucks here, but like the mountains are covered in snow. And
it's just because you're not Mormon.
Super pretty.
You're not in the Holy Land.
It's beautiful, but everything around it, like the government and the fucking people.
Boo. Yeah, it's just ran completely shitty. I'm surprised they didn't like search us coming in to make sure we didn't have fucking 4.5% beers.
No, people make false trunks in their cars to import the booze.
There's still like moonshine running.
Yeah, shit. A Coors Light running.
Like where NASCAR is still a way of life.
There's no NASCAR tracks in Utah though.
Did you get a mixed drink there yet?
Nope. I have not.
Try that.
None of us did.
I want to see if the margarita still has the sidecar of fucking alcohol on the side of it.
Should we go back to the same bar?
No, go to Applebee's.
Go to Applebee's. The best, the most highfalutin.
We did go to Applebee's. We did go to Applebee's last night because that bar had garbage food. We asked about food and they're like, oh, we're only going to make from this up on the menu. And it was just like shitty appetizers. It was like deep fried cheese. Fuck you. And they're like, it's like $10 for some deep fried cheese bites. Fuck you. So we went to Applebee's like right before they closed and they were not stoked.
Gotcha.
But we went in and got some like half price appetizers and it didn't cost us shit. And they let us eat it. They gave us to go orders, but they just kind of let us hang out until they closed. And we found out that they are actually probably going to have some weird changes with the beers because Budweiser and everybody doesn't even want to make it anymore because it's not cost effective.
That makes a lot of sense. States.
Good. Fuck
it's only
that
three
whole
states
place.
That have it now. So I don't know what they're going
to
do.
That'll force Utah into having to either
wake the fuck up.
Yeah. Well, you know what, though? Like, Utah has a problem with the half-beer bullshit, but there's still, like, places back east that are, like, dry counties.
Is another one.
They have dry counties in Utah.
That's so fucking weird. Yeah. Like, what is it stopping? You're just going to make somebody drive a little farther to get the same fucking thing.
You could be in the same city.
And then drink it on the way back and crash.
Yeah, you could be in a different... You could be in the same city, a different county, and not be able to buy a thing. It's horrible.
Fucking dumb, man.
My family's from there, like I've said... bunch of times, but I've only would go there on the holidays where everybody's off work,
right?
So we'd have to go to different fucking counties, like everybody's times off of work. It's fucking terrible.
It solves nothing. It stops nothing. Stop it. Just fucking stop it. It's 2018, man.
Hey, props to the Applebee's in Layton, Utah, because they were super cool and hanging out, talking.
Because they know what the rest of the fucking country's like, god damn it.
Yeah, Applebee's is woke as fuck.
Oh, I wouldn't say that.
Dude.
Alan's culture popped out when he thinks Applebee's is woke.
Members of the Belluminati.
Half price appetizers?
The Belluminati, man.
We'll get into that.
Jesus.
We'll get into that later. Fucking.
So yeah, that was my night last night. It was pretty interesting. Utah's been pretty much work nonstop the whole time I've been here. So it was nice to go out, even though we got kicked out, but it made for a fun story.
Go there again.
We got back to the hotel and like just randomly both of us just start laughing. Like, hey, we fucking got kicked out for vaping.
I'm smitten that the first time you drank in 2018, you got thrown out of a bar. It's really good.
Yeah, so. Starting the year off right.
Good job,
good
Dylan. Time.
Good job. I've got thrown out of.
I want you to do, Dylan, is I want you to go inside a fucking Mormon temple.
No, he's going to become Mormon. Remember,
I don't think that you can't just go into those.
No, you can. They're
goddamn church.
They're
go.
Tourist as fuck. You just go to them.
Well, you just can't get married in one, huh?
No,
unless you're like.
Well,
part
you're
of
gay, life. So no, you can't get married.
You'll step foot in there and like. Start like burning.
Yeah, you have to.
That's what I'm hoping for. So go to the fucking temple.
They strip you down.
The Mormons
and tell me what Joseph Smith tells
the right
you.
Ones.
Yes.
They strip you down and look at your magic underwear and they're like, nope, he doesn't have it.
No signs
I'm
of fisting
wear my
hair.
Fucking long johns
There's
I
no
bought,
mana
man. I got
here.
Magic underwear.
There's no mana.
They sniff
in
you.
These drawers.
I bought my fucking insulated underwear that look like him. It's close enough. I got hillbilly underwear.
This is
dude.
Not the queen.
Spit on the non-believer.
Spit on the non-believer.
I don't even know this joke yet.
Will you go around the Mormon church and spit on non-believers, please? Please?
Until you get kicked out. Yes. Keep going. Just keep going to the next one.
Oh, my God. All right.
You don't you don't believe hard enough and just spit in their face?
Spit on the unbeliever.
The unbeliever.
What about you, Dave? You joined Scientology yet or what?
Yeah, you were supposed to work on that last week.
Yeah,
what happened?
I didn't. I've been busy working.
You can't be too busy for Scientology.
Well, I mean, I know a lot about Scientology. I just didn't go down there.
Will you go down there this week?
No, I can't promise you that.
Why?
Because I got shit going on. I got to go to L.A. pretty soon. And
Take your personality test. Let's go together.
Yeah. Okay, I'm in another state right now, and I joined the Mormon religion. Fuck me.
He went to Utah secondarily to work. Primarily.
To join the Mormon
religion. Join the Mormons.
I'd love to infiltrate the
just do a week.
Local Scientology.
I want you for 1 week to be in Scientology.
1 week and $10,000, Dave. It's going to cost you, but
you can do it.
Yeah, there we go. after I get back from LA, I'll look into
you. You guys got a busy schedule, you and Dylan.
Yeah,
joining religions. You got your fitness challenge coming up too.
Oh yeah, so after the fitness challenge,
all right. Yeah, you guys are still doing that.
Yeah, there's still spots open.
You got to do it.
I mean, what?
Dude, we have a backup for that if that one.
I'm honestly concerned about Dave's health with the Spartan Jesus race. Christ.
Yeah, because here's what's going on. Dave and Dylan have a challenge with each other of who's healthier or more fit.
It's more fit.
More fit. I don't think
better
health,
shape.
Health is not a thing
it.
Between these two. But who is more fit? And we were going to do a shitty obstacle course out here, but we found the Spartan race coming up in, February, mid-February?
Yeah. Or the balloon race.
Or the balloon
inflatable
race.
Thing.
The inflatable
well, that's,
obstacle
that's a
5K
as well.
So
I'm thinking more of that one because
I don't want Dave crawling through the mud
with his fucking dangers to his health.
I can wear goggles. Fuck off.
Dude, it'd be so funny if you wore goggles during the Spartan race.
What? I've seen people wear goggles during the Spartan race. They don't even have a giant hole in their face.
It's got rocketeer goggles.
What you have to crawl under?
Yes. I've actually, after you said something about barbed wire last week, I was like, oh shit. Ooh. So I went home and I Googled it and I was like, oh fuck.
Yeah, it's intense.
No, I honestly think I'll do all right.
People travel
states. I would worry about your safety. That's all. Not even because I don't think
there's a couple obstacles. I don't think you're tall enough to get up. I'm not even kidding. Like there's a couple of things where
Dave boost me.
Yeah, like he'd be like, I need something off the top shelf. Dave, help me out.
Dave
you
is
know,
a sinewy.
You missed the perfect.
A sinewy, taut specimen.
Yeah,
he can do this.
Can do it.
Got his Daniel Craig horse muscles out, dude. I see it.
I do.
He's got a third leg, too. It's an unfair advantage.
I don't make jokes about my own penis.
Good.
What the fuck?
Oh, fuck. Dylan, did you watch any movies this weekend?
Yeah, I watched that one I was supposed to watch last
weekend.
You did
your homework.
Finally, yeah. It took you 2 weeks to get through one movie. I'm proud of you.
Quick catch up.
Three tries.
We didn't watch a movie last night.
No, because he had to redo the one from last week.
Dylan
it took
is
me three attempts, but I got it.
Dylan is programmed now to watch a movie every week.
A movie that everybody has seen and he hasn't.
Yes, it's in the zeitgeist of popular. Everybody has seen movies, and so far he's done
Predator,
Aliens,
Top Gun.
Everybody's seen those. Now, this week, we've
is
got
that
him
all I've done?
Yeah, you've done three.
And the one this week.
Fuck.
And then this week, yeah, this fucking piece of shit.
This week, Dylan watched
Ghostbusters.
Oh, yeah, Ghostbusters.
Oh, yeah, Ghostbusters was one. Forgot
God
about
damn it, he was
four.
Right.
Fucker.
We fucked up and he was right.
Yeah.
Kill his feed. Get him out of here.
Get used to it.
our internet's going.
Bye, Dylan.
Fuck.
All right, so Dylan this week did The Fifth Element.
So what do you think of The Fifth Element there, Dylan?
So let's clear it up. I didn't not finish the movie the first time because I didn't like it. I was very tired and I fell asleep. And then I tried to watch it again. I was very tired and fell asleep.
God damn it.
But I eventually got through it.
Do you remember anything from the movie being tired and not enjoying it as it sounds?
So I was thinking about it this morning, the scene when he like walks outside and it's like New York with all the flying cars and all that shit.
Yeah.
That looked really good.
It still holds up to this day.
Like, it still looks really good. I'm like, damn, good job.
Like that whole car chase.
That run around the big goofy fucking orc looking alien dudes.
I forget their names.
Yeah, I can't remember.
But go on.
But do continue. My music's really loud and I can't hear you guys. Sorry. So the alien dudes were a little goofy looking. Mm-hmm. So I didn't.
The dogs?
That was. Is that what they? I don't know. I don't remember what their names were. The guys that were trying to steal the chick.
The guys that worked for Zorg.
Yeah.
The guys
yeah.
Were,
so
they didn't say their name.
So there was a scene where like that guy's standing there, and then like some like grease shit starts dripping down his head. Was that supposed to be like his? What was going on? Was he sweating and his hair grease was no. dripping?
That's
down?
Blood.
That's blood.
Gary Oldman.
It happened earlier in the movie too with one of the
Mangalore.
The general out in space.
Yeah, when the evil is talking to them, they just start bleeding from their foreheads.
Yes.
But why was it brown and greasy looking?
Blood is dark, dude.
That was blood.
It didn't look like blood at all. It looked like grease from.
It looks like tar. Yeah.
Pure
yeah.
evil then.
Yeah, maybe it is pure evil.
The alien race in question, the dog-looking ones, as you so eloquently put it, yeah. are Mangalores.
Mangalores, there you go.
Ah, Mangalores.
Yeah. So.
Bruce Willis is awesome in everything he does.
Yeah, it's kind of, at one point it gets like Die Hard in space. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Die
the
Hard
car chase scene, you can't say the car chase in that movie sucks.
No.
It's fucking awesome.
It's really good.
It's a three-dimensional car chase, dude.
Yeah.
It's fucking awesome.
And come on, like, Mila Jehovah's boobs.
Jehovah's?
Like, Mila Jehovah's Witness bitch. Dave's stuck on religion.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Get over it.
I hate that shit.
Yeah, she's super hot.
Yes.
I like the goofiness of the movie.
Yeah.
It's kind of silly.
It's serious and not at the same time, and that's what makes it.
Kind of feels like a comic book.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can, yeah.
That dude makes rad movies. I still
this
have to
scene
see
where
Valerian.
This chick's doing the singing part that's playing right now is pretty cool, too.
Plava Laguna.
Yep, that's Plava Laguna, bro. Get with the
is
lore.
That, is that who that is?
Mm-hmm.
See,
the blue tentacle chick?
See, Matt's doing the thing that you should be doing when you're here and providing us with vital information on the
I know Plava Laguna's name deep,
yeah.
though.
No, yeah.
I just assume that he knows all this stuff and doesn't
actually,
know.
Actually, he does.
I do.
As we're watching it, he's all telling me all this crazy stuff.
I could
stuff
not remember
it,
Mangalore,
you know?
Though.
No, I couldn't remember
I remember
either.
Manashewan.
Manashewan.
Yeah.
Evil, the fifth element.
Go ahead, Dylan.
And
please continue.
Chris Tucker was awesome. Like, the whole cast was great.
Chris Tucker's over the fucking top.
Ruby Rod, dude.
Yeah.
You nervous in the service? And he shoves that fucking mic to his face like, not really.
The music all stops and shit.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Dude, in the airport scene when he's fucking going down on that chick and then the fucking landing gear sound going up and her legs are going up. I don't want one position. I want all positions.
I want all positions.
So weird. What's that fucking 90210 guy? Luke Perry is his name?
This was 97, early 97 when it came out. So that was when that shit was ending, I believe. So he had a little bit of street cred movie-wise back then.
Yeah, he was only in for like 30 seconds.
He got the first 5 minutes of the movie and that's it.
Yeah. Fucked it all up by shooting that thing.
Aziz Light. The Manashewan walk up on him is like, are you German? I've watched that movie too many fucking times. Dylan has watched it
three times. No, you got
one.
It once.
I give it one.
He fell asleep in it twice.
Three attempts, one watch.
It's one I'll watch again, I'm sure.
It's one to put on rotation just when nothing's going on. Just throw it on the background.
Yeah.
It was also on HBO's and Showtime's just like a lot with us three
who
are in Phoenix right now.
Sorry, I wasn't privileged enough to have that.
Yeah, that's what happens when you grow up fucking Whitman.
In a stack of priorities, electricity's above cable.
Yeah.
So
I think so. You hook an alternator up to a bicycle to power the cable box.
The cable don't come out here, man. You gotta get satellite. Hey,
my satellite. Issue with movies that I realized from this movie is that I do get sleepy watching movies, and then I kind of just nod out of them sometimes. It's not anything to do with the movies. It's just that I don't know. I don't like sitting down for that long just watching something.
So you need people there with you.
You don't fucking sit there and stare at your goddamn phone for 2 hours, though.
Yeah.
You gotta watch.
Yeah, but he's doing like six different things on his phone all at once.
Well, no, no.
No, it is. That's what it is, man. We're trained. Scrolling Facebook, checking his Instagram, swiping right.
I don't just sit on my phone and do nothing else.
He just keeps looking at his dick pics.
This is a really good one, guys.
The lighting on this is fucking...
Look at the shadows.
Did you guys get all those nudes I sent in the chat today?
Yeah.
A little tasteful.
So yeah. what do you give it for out of Dylons?
I'm going to give it 4 Dylons.
4 Dylons. That's not bad.
Yeah. We
I
haven't
wonder
had
if anything's going to be a 5. I don't think we're going to get a 5.
I think we'll get a 5 out of you.
Maybe.
Oh, there was a fucking request for a movie for me to watch, actually, but I don't know if you guys agree with it.
Throw it out. What is it?
Justin Poff said I need to watch Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
Oh, hey, you know, I
don't think I've seen that.
I'll allow it, but it's not a movie everybody has
no,
seen.
No, I haven't seen it.
Yeah.
I know a lot about it.
I understand. Yeah, it isn't in the same realm as the movies we should normally be picking, but I love that movie. I love that book. I love everything.
Love that ass.
That shit.
That ass.
Zooey Deschanel's ass.
So what do we want to get Dylan to watch next week? You guys have any ideas?
Total Recall comes to mind.
That's a good one.
That's a good one, yeah. Ooh, that's a really good one.
We haven't done an Arnold movie
in a while. The Arnold one. Bring it back.
Yeah, not the remake.
No, we can't. No remakes. Unless, no, I don't think any remakes.
I will say the remake of RoboCop shits all over the original RoboCop
movies.
It's
pretty good.
I liked it.
I just don't like that it's PG-13.
I don't like the original RoboCop movies at all. I think they're terrible.
I don't think they're terrible.
I thought they were trash as a kid. I was sitting there being like, fucking garbage. Like, when that shit already came out, like, Star Wars was the thing. I'm like, fucking try a little.
Right.
Fucking garbage ass robot
totally
man.
I
was just desperate for content, though. I just wanted to watch something.
I would
new.
Throw shut your fucking mouth at you right now, but I don't have that power this week.
Alan, when was the last time you watched a RoboCop movie?
I'd say within the last 2 years, I watched the original RoboCop.
It's terrible. Mouth. It is terrible.
It's awful. They're not good.
I enjoy the first one.
They're not. It's still not good.
I enjoy the first one.
They have funny lines you can sample
yeah,
all day for
like,
funny
the
musical
gore,
things.
Like, is pretty, you know, and like those commercials that they have.
It's
like,
80s as fuck.
It is 80s.
That's
fuck.
Why I think know, I like
there's,
it.
There's. It's not good by any means, and I knew that when I was young too. But it's also entertainment.
I like when everybody's like, with that our friends podcast, there can be only one. They talk shit about like Batman versus RoboCop. RoboCop's so tight, but he gets fucking tricked by a little league team. Like, get the fuck out of me, dude. Fuck yourselves.
Did you guys see that fan video where it's that RoboCop just shooting a bunch of dicks off?
Yes, the fan made shit's way better.
That's probably one of the best things I've seen on the internet.
All right, so it's gonna be. Total Recall.
Arnold edition.
Arnold edition.
All right. That's a good one, I think.
Yeah. Totally. Right.
Give these people air. Yeah.
Cohagen. And it brings back.
Like a chick with 3 tits or something in it.
Yep.
Yeah.
Baby,
all right.
Baby, wish I had 3 hands. Yeah. You'll see it after 5 attempts, you fucking asshole.
Yeah,
I got things to do, man.
I got a question. I got a serious question. How long are you in Utah?
I will be back on the 19th, and then I leave again that following Monday, and then we'll be in Sacramento on the 26th, and then come home that weekend, and I leave again that next Monday, and then maybe that's it, I think.
How much are tickets in Sacramento to see you?
Tickets to see what?
To see you. You're on tour.
What are you charging? You're on tour life right now. Hashtag business trip.
Hashtag ain't seen home.
Hashtag world traveler. Yeah.
Dylan's world tour.
Tour life. I'm going to go ahead and save $55 with a $47 service fee.
That's pretty good. Oh, service fees.
What was the service fee? What?
$47.
Damn. It's less than the ticket, so you're getting a deal.
You have to listen to the podcast live to expect people to listen to it on their off time, Dave.
I don't understand live podcasts.
I got nothing.
I want to go see a podcast live because people do it like
at the comedy clubs?
Yeah.
I'm going to one.
It just seems weird to go watch just a bunch of dudes sit at a table and talk and you just sit there and watch them.
I'm actually going to go do that in Portland next month.
Yeah, so Alan booked a thing that's pretty rad.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the Dick Show's live show. It's called Road Rage, and they're doing Portland. So I'm going to fly up there on the Saturday and experience this and fly home Sunday morning at like 5. So
you're just going to watch?
Yeah, I'm going to go watch, hang out, and then come home. It's going to be, it's going to be fun. I've never been to, because the way they set theirs up is it's everybody from the show, from their podcast.
So Stereos will be there?
I believe so.
Oh.
Yeah.
Have you guys spoke?
No, I'm going to have to apologize to him.
Why? You should probably talk to him.
I will. Yeah. I will talk to him. But what they do, instead of setting it up as like them sitting around a table doing the podcast, they set it more like a comedy show where they're sitting in a line on chairs and shit and have like bits and bullshit, and it's pretty fun.
Okay,
so we'll see how it goes.
It seems like it can work, but like some podcasts I don't see working out. Like I don't think that we could do that.
Why not?
Weird. You I don't just, think anyone would care.
No,
you're in a fucking hotel room in Utah.
You need a large fan base, which we're brand new, so what do you expect, man?
We have the best fans, though. We so many do.
You guys rule.
Did you see...
We got a new one in where? Kentucky? Louisiana? Where was
it? We got a Kentucky listener.
Yeah.
We got another one in Australia. What's
another
up?
Another one? Hey. Yeah.
Good day.
Good day, mate.
Cunt. No, wait. I'm fucking... good day, mate.
Good day, cunt.
No.
You don't have one for Kentucky?
I haven't said cunt yet.
No, I was going to have some banjos play and say hi, but I don't have that track, so... Just hi, Kentucky and Manitoba, Canada. Somehow,
it's just a bunch of dudes saying how hot their cousins are.
Yeah,
all of our Canadian listeners are from Manitoba.
Yeah, it's all of middle Canada.
I don't know how that's happening, but we welcome you.
Log cabins up there, right? There's no cities, right?
Hey, they get the show.
Well, they got internet.
Well, thanks for listening, eh?
God,
smash
damn
that like button.
Just fuck up everybody's national slang. Yeah.
Bring me a Molson. We're going to listen to this show.
God damn it.
Oh, hey, you guys like Rick Moranis up there?
Boy, do I.
Is that Strange Brew?
Yeah.
Hey, is Strange Brew a fucking movie that everybody's seen?
No.
That's not.
It's almost. It's.
I haven't seen it.
So that one and... Slapshot, you ever see that one?
I've never even heard of that one.
Nope. It's a hockey movie from the same era, same director, but it's got Paul Newman and a couple other folks. But it's all Canadian as fuck.
I think another good one.
What about
would be,
the Kids in the Hall Brain Candy? That movie's fucking.
It was, but that was again though.
Not everybody's seen.
Yeah, not everybody's seen.
You need a movie like Trading Places.
Yeah. There you go. Yeah. Or Coming to America.
Yeah. Trading Places is better though.
Sure. Well, Trading Places.
Happy New Year!
I have no legs.
Trading Places was genius.
Yeah, dude.
So there you go, Dylan. We're gonna.
Yeah, we got all kinds of stuff coming.
We need to build the queue up a little bit because I wasn't sure what we were gonna.
And
pick
if anybody
this week.
Anybody has
all
suggestions,
those sounded terrible.
Our Facebook page. Fuck let up, us Dylan. Know what Dylan should see, or you can email us.
NFHCPodcast@gmail.com.
Boom.
NFHCPodcast
at Twitter, whatever.
And if it's facebook.com/NFHCPodcast.
Yeah. Yep.
And we're getting our Instagram set up this week. So
if you don't remember, just Google NFHCPodcast, all one word. I'm sure all of it will come up because
we're putting it everywhere.
Everywhere. Try it.
We got a metadata. We got to fucking tag metadata and shit in our pictures and stuff.
We're gonna be more worldwide than Pitbull.
Worldwide, fuck yeah,
Mr. Worldwide.
Whoa,
Alan,
how did that? I don't know how that happened.
Alan, it's fucking
new. Alan, you guys want to talk to my mom?
Interview your mom. Yeah. That's how easy it is to talk on a phone call.
I'll do it.
No.
No, it'd be annoying. She's annoying.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Now put her on.
Yeah.
She carried you for 9 hard months. You had to be a big...
8 months. I was premature. That explains a lot.
Because if it came out at 9, you would have split her to the bottom of her teats.
Yep.
Oh, my God.
He's a big fucker. Look at it. Big baby. Hey.
I'm a big dude. My kids were big.
And we've been carrying Alan for 9 episodes.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
I gotta kick my feet up. You guys take this. Put this fucker on cruise. Say, so, hey, Dave, you ready to? Are you stable well,
he's
right
got,
now?
He's got some shit he's done this week that's pretty interesting.
What'd you do?
He was on the news.
Yeah. What? You were on the news?
Well, yeah, we were. Yeah.
Which channel?
12.
Oh.
All of the Daves?
All of the Daves.
Well, the school that I work for, the day program, we've got a special needs hockey team called the Bobcats.
Nice.
And they had their first exhibition game at Gila River Arena, where the Coyotes play. So I hung out there all day yesterday, and, you know.
So when did you talk to the news?
Yeah, I did. But
did they mistake you for a student rather than instructor?
Really, Alan? Really?
Did you do a big Tonya Harding triple sow cow land all perfect?
No, but I'm about to Galooly Allen.
Did were you like breaking knees and shit to like outskate people?
Yeah, well, yeah. Absolutely. Fuck, here we go.
Oh,
no,
man.
Yeah, so that was cool.
I'm sorry, the I'm just fucking
was,
around.
The event was great. The hockey thing was kind of like a fluke, an afterthought. Like Jared did this whole music thing with, and that it's huge, you know. I mean, and then all of a sudden, like, he's like, hey, let's try out this hockey thing. He knows a lot of people. He plays hockey still. Floated the idea out to a couple of people he played hockey with, and it just snowballed. And I mean, they've got all the gear that they will ever need for like 10 seasons. They've got like I mean, it's a great thing. It's the first special needs hockey team in Arizona.
So who do they play against?
Well, each other.
Oh,
we've got a lot of members. There was
this school's big.
Yeah, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 campuses.
Two locations.
No shit.
Well, yeah,
killing it.
Two major locations in Phoenix, but then we also have vocational location. We also have a culinary location, and we just opened a school up out in just south of San Francisco in a town called Moreno.
See, I had no idea it was this big of a thing.
Yeah, I didn't either. Yeah.
I thought Dave worked at one little place.
Yeah.
Well, and I'll tell you what, like, I don't want to throw my back out jerking this dude off, but Jared Woosley,
we're used to it with him. He used to talk about him.
He started, fuck off.
There's anime hearts flying out of your eyes every time you're like, well, Jared.
Jared.
Did you go to Jared?
He started working at this.
He went to Jared.
He started working at this joint, like, after 5-Speed broke up and, like, things were, like, low or whatever, you know, like, he started working at this joint just as, like, you know, the past, like, I mean, he's got some connections. His mom has, like, one of the last cases of polio in the United States, so, like, you know, her legs.
Whoa.
Yeah, weird, right? So he's got...
Vaccinate, you damn kid.
Not if David Wolf has anything to do with it.
He started working at this place or whatever, you know, and they were just, like, you know, there was, I think, like, 45 or 50 members of this program, and he... worked there for a few months, and somebody ended up donating a drum set, and it literally snowballed from there. Like, he started doing just dicking off with like some music classes or whatever, and then turning it into this huge thing, and it's going on 9 years later.
Is he the reason they're so big?
Yes.
The multiple locations,
pretty much.
Holy
damn.
I'd say 80% of it.
I understand the anime hearts flying out of your eyes right now. Yeah, in real time.
Yeah. Like, I mean, they had like 40, 50 members when he started there. And I mean, don't get me wrong, they've got a good team there, and they got a lot of, like, some good, you know, money people.
And then there's you.
Grant writers. Well, yeah.
Dave.
I got dirty dumb Dave. Fucking luck falling into this job. Like, it's the best job I ever had. But so it snowballed from over the course of, like, well, I started working there. It's 2 years next week. And, we had, between all five locations, 500 and something members.
Jesus.
Yeah. Like, from 50.
Yeah.
40 or 50.
That's crazy.
And it's mostly because of the draw of the music program. Don't get me wrong. Music isn't the only thing keeping things going. It's actually a pretty small spoke of the whole deal. One of the coolest, in my opinion.
You guys should...
it spawned...
You're the biggest spoke there, brother.
Yeah. Are you guys going to put in like a tactical gun range, race car track, horseback riding? I don't know.
We've got a
I'm just throwing out ideas.
Gym.
What else could they do?
We got a big dance floor.
Oh, that'd be fun.
And we've got an art room with a couple of clay wheels.
Skydiving.
Do you guys ever reenact Ghost with the clay wheels?
There's a couple girls I would, though, with.
What?
Yeah, there's some hot chicks that work there.
No. Oh, that work there.
Work, okay. Yeah, come on.
Okay.
And these girls are like, you know, they got some compassion, you know, because they work.
You're better than that, Dave.
Oh, hey, there's Dylan.
I'm not going to shit on your thing too much. Keep going.
No, so yeah, so, you know, and.
Hey, Dave's out there changing the world, but he's also collecting a paycheck, so I don't know how much shit.
Call that a paycheck.
Would you keep doing it if they paid you? I don't think you would. I know
how
you.
How good of a person are you?
Yeah.
I don't need the money. Like, I mean, like, when they... So I when do. They, when Give they me tell your money, me I need then. To start checking my email every day, and, like, they get me a desk and all that shit, and I'm just like... I don't need this fucking job, so I'm just going to keep doing what I'm fucking doing.
I don't need this fucking job.
Like, if you can find somebody that'll maintain these 12 guitars and fucking everybody's parts and, you know, play bass on
you
top.
You maintain the guitars there?
Yeah,
oh, like, my God.
Oh, God. They're fucked.
If you would see Dave's gear in our band.
Oh, shut up. My gear's great.
Makes me wonder.
Oh, you just wait till this year, though.
Hey, remember that one rehearsal like out. A week ago where knobs were falling off of your pedal board?
Like, that was my fault.
Just saying.
Like, that's... Look, I love my Helix. Line 6, endorse me. But I don't...
I'll make
like,
the knobs I mean, fall that, off
the,
better.
The volume knob, like, just the glue, like, broke free.
Wait, straight up, real quick. I know, the glue broke free on the knob. But you work at a place that's doing shit musically with... The kids and all the adults and all the things, call them. Get endorsed.
Yeah.
Endorsed by Line I've got 6 plenty too. Of endorsements.
For the I know. School. Hit up Line 6.
Yeah, no. Use them for your own personal.
That's a good idea.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
Dave, what is wrong with
he
you?
He didn't think about this till just
the kids,
right now.
But for me. No, but for the kids.
I did and I didn't. Well, because Jared handles most of that shit. He's a really good schmoozer.
Well, but. Schmooze Line 6 at NAMM.
Dave, listen to what I'm about to say to you. It's going to blow your mind. So... Let's say that there's a guitar player and he's in two bands. They didn't endorse him for just the one fucking band.
They endorsed the person.
He can use the guitars in both bands.
Your students require Line 6 Helix snapshots.
Yes.
Oh, yes, they do. Oh, and Variaxes?
Yeah.
Oh, my fuck. Yeah. I thought about that. I've thought about a Variax and a Helix together, the things that you can automate. Like I can change the Jeff tuning on the fly. Like
you can make that thing sound like a banjo and a sitar.
Yeah, or
except for he's gonna have to change his settings every practice.
You can just have somebody imagine him at work once a beat, and it would sound like whatever you wanted it to.
So these kids go there to learn how to play music. So do you sit there for 2 hours and fuck with everything before they play too, or is that just with us?
No, I play bass there mostly.
Oh, okay.
So three hours. I've got two tones. That's it.
Oh, Jesus. What a fucking mess.
That's one more tone than Alan has. Yeah, he's a professional.
Yeah.
I am a...
You are a professional.
I'm an endorsed artist, sir.
You do that one thing very fucking well.
Goddamn right. I got something. I do a thing.
I wish that Alan was endorsed for ESP Guitars and Ghost Walk, too, so he could use the guitars and Ghost Walk as well, but...
I do.
Not how that works,
that's
I guess.
Not how they work, according to Dave. Oh. The world,
what
according to Dave.
What does that even mean? When did I say that? Dicks.
You're like... You're like, I have all kinds of endorsements, but it's for the school.
They're program endorsements, but whatever.
They endorse the player, not the project. They believe in you.
You.
So get that Line 6 train
going.
Don't
hate the player,
hate
the game.
Yeah.
You know,
trickle
down Reaganomics. Give me one.
Matt, you got that news story ready to go?
Oh, yeah.
This
so,
is for Dave.
Dave. I hope you haven't heard about this, but here we go.
What makes Dave mad this week?
Oh, this is a theme song, you guys.
This is a good one.
What makes Dave mad this week?
Oh, man.
Everything.
Everything.
But in particular.
I haven't even gotten mad yet today.
What makes Dave mad this week?
Prepare your anus.
What makes Dave mad this week?
So it's a brand new segment we tried last week, and I might have went out the gates too hot.
Set the bar high.
I set the bar high. Cause well,
you should have saved the Alex Jones one, maybe. And not...
That one was a timely Star Wars release date.
Yeah, that had to,
it
be
had
done.
To happen.
That's well, true. You should have started true. It with that, in my opinion, because that David Wolf thing, fuck,
that,
man.
That is eternal.
That got yep. me heated.
He is eternal.
Heated.
So we this... can always resort to him for any time we really want to make Dave mad. So yeah. It's not like we'll end, run
Dave,
out of material.
Dave has heated arguments about things he finds completely dumb.
Yeah.
This sure. is...
And this week, I'm trying. This is a test. This might fall on its face. It might be great. That's the joy of trying this every week. But people are eating. People are eating Tide Pods, Dave.
I've seen the meme.
You've seen the meme.
But do you know what the effect of it has been?
Is that's really happening?
Yes, what? It is here. Really happening.
All right, let's see if this works.
In fact,
wait. People are really like sticking it in their Keurig or something. Like
no,
I saw
they're
that meme.
Biting into it. They're baking it on pizza.
They're yeah, putting it in burritos and
they're
shit.
Dabbing it.
Yeah,
like you know the like dabs? What they do with wax.
Yeah,
like with
they're
with,
dabbing
with
Tide Pods.
I watched that video. That was
are
ridiculous.
Are you fucking shitting me?
Okay, so I think it's working.
It's work.
You want the news report on it?
Yeah,
the local news even.
I think all this right. is from ABC yeah. 15, right?
I think so.
All right.
All new at 6, there's a good chance you got them in your home right now. Colored packs of chemicals meant for cleaning your clothes. But doctors say a dangerous social media trend has people biting into laundry no. pods and winding up in the emergency room.
ABC 15's John Genovese has the health warning that you need to hear.
No. Well, the companies behind these pods have made changes since they first came out. The containers are no longer see-through.
They look delicious.
The lids are more child-resistant, and some of the colors have changed. But now people are making jokes about eating them online, and doctors say they've seen cases where teens are following through.
A
dangerous health risk spreading through social media.
Can you handle the challenge?
Photos show laundry pods being used as pizza toppings, a bowl of them mixed with bleach for breakfast, and even people posting videos biting into them for real.
It's very similar to what happened years ago, the cinnamon challenge.
But Banner Health toxicologist Dr. Frank Lavecchio says this is far worse.
It can cause a burn to your mouth, your lips, your breathing tube, your feeding tube, your esophagus.
And before the liquid comes another concern.
The membrane around it, when it dissolves, can cause central nervous system depression.
Last year, Arizona Poison Center say there were 239 reports of laundry pod exposures across the state, including 140 in Maricopa County.
The American Association of Poison Control Centers has
said
this is
a big risk. And that's just the people that went to the ER.
Now, spokesman for Procter & Gamble, the company behind Tide, says the colors used in these detergent pods have a purpose when it comes to cleaning your clothes. And they and health officials say, especially when you have kids at home, you need to store these containers
put them next
up
to
high
Percocets
and out
in
of
the
their
cupboard.
Reach. For now, John Genovese, ABC 15, Arizona.
All right, John, thank you.
Oh, my fucking God.
I'm calling Poe. That's Poe's Law. That was not a bowl of Tide Pods. That was a hack Photoshop job.
You
of,
see the pizzas with it baked on?
That was real, but that was Poe. That was sarcasm. I guarantee you those pizza pictures, and that's all Poe. That is Poe's Law in full effect. And these dumb motherfuckers on the news, they fucking fell for it.
We have video evidence. You ready?
Dave, check it.
This is
they're saying that people making the fake memes are causing people to eat them.
Yes.
239 cases in our own state last year.
And that's so just 239 reported. Out of 7 million people in roundabout in Phoenix.
But that's just reported. Right.
How many of those are kids, and how many of those could have accidentally gotten...
How do you accidentally eat a Tide Pod? I was taking it out of the cupboard, and it fell into my mouth.
Have you never heard of, like, a 3 or 4-year-old getting under the cupboard and drinking some bullshit? And then, you know, like, I mean, that shit happens, Alan.
So you did.
You're a goddamn parent, and you're...
He's barely a parent.
My Tide Pod.
Let's make one thing very clear. He's Blair's the parent. He just lives here.
He's the kid. God.
He's
don't reinforce that idea with her.
He's the fifth child.
He's the one that eats a lot.
Yeah,
and I'm saying
his meme game is strong though.
Strong as fuck.
That's how he keeps her.
The Tide Pods in a bowl pouring bleach on it was a Photoshop meme, but people are like, "Huh, that looks delicious."
Yeah, but then did you see the girl who bit into it when she spit it out?
Yeah,
you know, because she knew it was going to be disgusting.
Awful.
Yeah, like so those three examples are a very piss poor way, and 239.
But did like, you listen to the news report, Dave?
Yes, and it's sensational and scary, and I'm fucking having a panic attack just thinking about it right now. But the reality of the situation is that is a fucking troll. And the, like, the
it's news, a troll that's tricking dumb people.
It is, including the news. But I mean, Dave, there's no, Dr. I guarantee you, there. I mean, like, God damn it. Good fucking here, job, Dave. Pat. God damn it.
Dave.
Oh, man.
Here's somebody on YouTube dabbing it.
You better dab me some Tide Pod.
Yeah! You're gonna die, bro. I hope you die. You fuck.
Look. No edit.
Ooh. Ooh. Oh, that's hot.
Oh, ooh. You. I hope he died. He just.
And then he bites into one.
Yeah. That's the kind of person who I hope dies.
So.
Like, I do not want to pay his medical bills when the time comes. I do not want to. You know, I don't. He should just go find a cliff and throw himself off it.
He punched a hole in the liquid, put it in that shit, and then fucking dabbed it.
He for those of you who don't know what a dab is,
yeah,
that it's a way to vaporize, consume different extracts, mostly THC, you know, wax and shit like that. But so he pours a Tide Pod into his big old dab rig, and he smokes the fucking shit out of it. He's inhaling it. I mean, he hits it hard. Hard.
That's and there was no time. Edit in that video.
None. Okay, so that's just...
So he's probably 238, because after that video, you don't know what happened.
Yeah, who knows? I hope,
and then
he died.
He washed that dab down by biting into one after.
Again, he spit it out. Like, I mean, that shit tastes horrible.
Oh, you know you're going to spit it out, but there's people that are just...
On the news story, they said that it's dangerous even just having that shit in your mouth.
Yeah. It's chemical.
Sure it is. Of course it is.
It's not just
you know what else
it.
Is dangerous is fucking drinking alcohol or fucking staring
that's
at the eclipse.
That's time tested
but the
through
president
the ages.
Did that. Like, I mean, it doesn't, you know, people do dangerous shit all the fucking time.
What shithole country did our president do this in?
Meanwhile, in Texas. It's just,
oh,
it's,
my God.
Yeah, come on. And enough of the politics. That was quick. Thanks.
So you like that?
Yeah, that was good, man. I'm fucking. You got me going, dude.
We need to get him the Fitbit, and I want a big screen above this TV that shows his heart rate.
Vitals. It's just got my vitals.
Yeah,
up there.
We just judge your vitals. Your vitals.
Oh man,
I've got some good records.
I want to be
judge's vitals.
The fireball has taken hold of my vowels.
The fire of ball.
Fucking Christ!
Eat the poo poo.
Speaking of eat the poo poo,
so.
That wasn't bad. That wasn't bad. That was good.
It was good.
You did set the bar high, though, because
I know
last week.
I don't know if this can be a weekly segment because it took me. I do have backup for this, though.
There's backups on backups.
You can always lean on the wolf of David.
Yeah, of course you can. I hate that fucking guy.
Not this wolf.
But I'm going to hold on. Wolf. I'm going to hold on to my backup for this because not a dumb thing does not happen every week to the point that makes Dave's.
No, yeah.
Head want to explode.
And it's got
to
be something that he doesn't know about almost.
The day
I saw the memes about the Tide Pod and like, but I don't watch TV news sort of thing. Like I don't, you know, I
don't either.
How'd you find that then?
The memes.
So you Googled it? I didn't bother Googling it.
This is why as an intellectual, Matt from NFHCPodcast gets his news by like that meme doesn't make sense to me.
So
and I roll it backwards and then I educate myself because I learn of the origins, the fucking seed.
I still don't know the
conception.
Noddy Way one with the little
seed
red guy.
Of the
yeah,
meme.
What's the Ugandan thing?
Oh boy.
This segues us into VR chat. This can be an addendum. See that word? Addendum?
That is a good word.
As an intellectual.
God damn it.
You had to repeat that, didn't you?
Yeah, because I'm fucking dumb, and it's like one of the three big words I know, Dave. We're going to talk about VR chat at all anyway, but this can be an addendum to fucking...
Yeah.
Love that song, it guys. Cuts off just so a good. Banger.
So VR Chat is a free application through Steam on PC and Mac, probably.
Probably.
It's just the imagine like a messenger chat where you can just get into it and talk to anybody that's logged into it at a time. There's no gameplay. Okay. There's no nothing. You walk around these different worlds and there's just treasure chests with avatars in them. And you just say, I want to be that guy. And then it changes the way you look inside the game for everybody else.
And then you just chat.
And you walk around and chat. You walk into bars.
Voice chat?
Voice chat, yeah. Everything.
And it's proximity.
And you see the avatar. Proximity chat. So if you're far away from somebody and there's a group talking and you're walking into the group, it fades in. So it's like real. It gives you like a sense of real space.
Yeah.
Okay.
You're in rooms, like physical fucking rooms or physical areas, and all you do is walk around
and talk to people.
And just talk to people.
So it's like going to the bar.
Yes.
It's a virtual bar.
Virtual bar.
And without you got to have BYOB.
Yeah, they have karaoke bars inside VR Chat. It's a free app on Steam. I got to download it. Alan downloaded it.
I got it. I'm going to experience
it. We need
it
to do
weekend.
A homework assignment in VR Chat. You don't need VR. You can control it like a first person shooter.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, then I can play it.
Yeah, after, no, uh-huh. We need to have
How much is it?
It's free.
It's free. Oh. Wow.
It's hacked as fuck, too, because people just dump avatars into it to be. Like, they upload their own work.
Oh.
Their shitty 3D animation. There's just, like...
Like, giant dolls.
There's bootleg versions of the Ghouls and Ghosts guy, Sonic.
There was a guy that was all thumbs.
All thumbs. Anime girls.
That's what it started out as, was people just talking to anime girls.
But it's usually dudes as a little lolly just running around.
Yeah.
This is...
So...
Well, god damn it.
I'm trying to figure out how to explain this, because this meme, the Ugandan Knuckles,
I do not do know
is
D-way.
So deep.
Are you the queen?
It's seven memes, I think, that come from different sources, all put together into this one glorious thing.
Of the mega meme.
Alan and I talking about it this week has us crying.
My chest hurts.
I don't even understand. Night. Like I feel so old right now.
Hold on, real quick. The Ugandan Knuckles guy.
Yeah, he's Knuckles. He's like a bootleg version of Knuckles from Sonic.
From Sonic. Okay. It started as this guy was reviewing. He was reviewing a Sonic game on his own YouTube channel.
I've seen that.
He drew Knuckles shitty,
yeah,
right,
and animated it, and it was for 2 seconds. Like, he just flapped his mouth a couple times. A deviant artist took it and made it a 3D model and put it into VR chat as the skin of the devil.
The devil.
And you have to go to the Ugandan server to get it. this is more complex. I didn't practice
Yeah.
So the very first Ugandan action movie ever came out in 2010.
Okay.
And it's amazing.
Called Who Killed Captain Alex? I have a little scene from this. We'll put all this shit in the links, I imagine.
Yeah, we'll try to link as much as we can.
But look at how shitty this animation is. The CD
Ugandan Air Force.
This CGI masterpiece.
Oh, wow.
He's like in the bed of a truck.
The man is killing us, man.
They superimposed a fucking helicopter on the side of the truck and Photoshop type Ugandan Air Force on the side.
Oh, wow.
It's just chaos.
Wow.
So all of the talking of the Ugandan Knuckles comes from this movie.
Yes.
All of the dialogue.
Okay.
Okay, look how... That's so shitty. Okay,
it's
anyway.
It's terrible. Oh, my God.
And then another scene from the movie is...
The acting is amazing.
This chick's running away from a guy. He pulls up. Ugandan is fucked. Like, why are you running?
Why are you running?
Okay.
Okay.
Why are you running?
It's an A1 fucking...
So this is where you come into play, because you play Player Unknown's Battlegrounds on Steam a lot.
Well, yeah.
People took the dialogue from this movie into PUBG, and they would create an entire team, like all these friends in like a fucking Discord, would all make like black avatars as Ugandan people, and they would not pick up weapons, and they would run after another player trying to be a thing.
In like a horde, dude.
In a horde. And they would have soundboards running through the game's audio of clips from that movie, and they would ambush these people just trying to punch them.
Yeah.
So I have a clip of that.
Yeah, this is so good.
Oh, no, they're coming.
And they blast out music through the in-game audio. They're coming.
Bro. He just fucking panics. Look at him panic. Where do I go?
Oh, fuck. Oh, my God.
There's so many.
Hear that? Quake. That's a fucking scene from that movie.
This guy.
Oh my god, there's so many.
He's like 30 people behind him just trying to punch him.
He's just like shotgunning him and running, dude. It's so good. Ah!
Oh my god.
Fuck yeah, dude.
I wanted a match with these dudes.
Ugandah!
Screaming Ugandah over and over again.
I want the bullets.
Damn, that guy was murdering.
Yeah,
they have no weapons. It's easy.
But all those dudes do that in random PUBG servers.
I want to get video, in on one guys. Of those, dude. Fuck off, Dylan. We don't need you anymore.
You gave us your half-ass movie review.
Yeah, thanks, bro.
So, all of those memes have combined into that dude drawing that guy into VR chat. And then on the Ugandan server, because you can pick like countries you want to be in, and it's a different map layout. The Ugandan one's a map, a island with a volcano.
Yeah.
And near the volcano, there's a treasure chest with this shitty ass avatar in it. So everybody picks that, and in fashion of PUBG, they form up giant squads of that.
Pipe in audio and so just go run around screaming.
This one comes in hot.
Spit on your brothers.
So they ruin people's conversations in this nice 3D space.
With 30 of them.
Back to spitting.
This ain't new.
You didn't know what it was.
No, but I didn't know this particular.
He's the queen. You're the queen.
What's that game, Second
Brothers.
Life? You remember that game, Second Life? Yeah. I remember watching videos of dudes.
Mr. Addicted Honey Man. Yelling at the Winnie the Pooh avatar.
Oh, look at all the fucking.
Winnie the Pooh.
What?
I can't
hear it. Everyone, clap for the queen.
Clap for the queen.
And then they clap. You two are the queen.
There cannot be two queens. There is only one queen.
Wait, why is it
this is the queen? There is spit on the fake queen.
So this is ruining VR chat.
Well, good, because VR chat's fucking ridiculous.
Oh, man, I'm participating in this tonight.
We haven't played it yet.
Look at that.
Yeah, and they go nuts over it. Watch, keep playing it for just a second. Watch what they do.
Oh, my brothers! My brothers!
This is definitely the way.
This is the most ridiculous thing I've ever laughed at.
There's no end to the YouTube fucking videos of this
shit.
Oh, it hurts. That's the actual soundboard from that movie this guy's playing right now.
You guys are feeding the Christians to the lions right now.
Yeah, and I don't give a fuck because this makes me cry at night when I'm tired and laughing as fuck.
Dylan, do you realize that we are half of a podcast where the other half is literally the downfall of society?
Oh, okay.
The downfall of society.
Yeah, we're the scourge.
The dab fall.
See? There it is.
Well, you wanted to know, so I took you through it.
Yeah, thank. I appreciate that. That's a good cap.
And all these links will be in the show notes, yes. By the way.
Good luck.
Propagate this bullshit to all you.
Good luck in that rabbit hole.
Find people out there.
You yourself said you wanted to be in a Player Unknown's Battlegrounds of the similar thing.
I do. Well, just because I want to shoot people in the face, like.
But the funny easily. Thing is, in VR chat, you have no weapons, so these people like, are just subject to this.
And hey, Dave. So I remember watching videos on this Reddit thread.
You are not the queen.
Some years ago, about that game Second Life, where this dude figured out a hack to where he could just spawn a Spartan every second. And the Spartans would just run screaming, rah! And they all look like Leonidas, you know, fucking from 300.
Oh my God.
And they just go running through areas screaming. And they would kind of like, they would kind of on purpose head towards like the places where other players were.
Right, the populated areas.
And then the super populated areas, there'd be like 10,000 of these, and it'd crash people's games and just scream, running around screaming, you know?
That's
like,
so good.
See, I appreciate.
That's a good troll.
The not harmful troll. Right. They're just because you know when somebody's being a dick in a game, you mute that one person. But there's like 40 deep of these.
Do you know it?
A visual with words I could try to give is the Ugandan Knuckles is about a foot and a half off the ground, so they're very small. And whatever avatar you are, you take their height. So if you're 6 foot, you're looking down, you're like, what the fuck is all this screaming? And you look down and they're just clucking, telling you that, are you the commander? You are not the queen.
You are not the queen.
If you're not the queen, they make up like 30 people making spitting sounds. Or
spit on the non-believer.
As they're looking for the queen, they'll all start sniffing. But when that's stacked with 40 people, it just gets loud as shit.
Fuck, man.
It's so fucking good.
I'm serious in 90% of my life, so I need a little bit of fucking fuckery to like just be like balance it all out.
Just smoother on out.
It's so good, dude.
Oh.
Can I sing again?
They'll play dumb flutes.
Yes. Sure.
Welcome to my mind,
So
look at he's all fucking.
Yeah, the player right now, his point of view, he's laying on the ground to get down to his level. That's how small they are. So you'll
that's annoying as shit.
So if we were doing, which a lot of people actually do their podcasts in VR chat, they'll go to like one of the weird bars and they'll do that and they get the whole feed and they record it because the audio is good. But then you have a fucking little tiny Knuckles jump in the middle of your table that your avatar's sitting in, be like, this one is the false queen. And then 30 more come in and they start just
spit on the non-believer. Spit on him.
This is terrible.
Yeah, so.
What a waste of fucking time.
Is it, though?
No, it's not. Not if I'm, like, dead laughing the whole time. It's perfect.
Yeah, I understand.
It's making good... actually doing it, I don't think... I don't have time for that. But I can enjoy people's little, like, perfectly edited clips of the best parts of it. Solid.
Spit on him.
Spit on the non-believer.
Oh, fuck.
So...
what else we got? What else we got going on? What's been...
the... fucking Lana Del Rey Radiohead lawsuit.
Oh, yeah. Have you heard about this, Dave?
No.
Radiohead suing Lana Del Rey for copyright infringement.
Is it Lana or Lana?
Whatever. I don't know. I think it is Lana.
Is it virulent or viral?
Did you upset Dave so mad that he just said whatever to you saying a word wrong?
Yeah.
Like, he's so just burnt out now that he didn't even acknowledge that you said something wrong?
Yeah.
I
need to finish this bottle here.
So anyway,
get in that F-ball.
I don't think Radiohead themselves are doing it, but they're so fucking micromanaged by firms. They're suing Lana Del Rey, for her new song. So I have I edited the back and forth of the two songs.
Let me hear it.
I'm going to let you hear it. Fortunately.
I have not heard of this at all.
So this is Lana Del Rey and... Radiohead
for creep.
This
my file is called Lana Del Rey's a creep.
This is my commitment, my modern manifesto.
It's the note structure for sure.
Yeah,
it's the progression, but it's like minor or it's major or something though, right?
Mm-hmm. Wait a minute.
Oh no, that's dead the fuck on.
Yeah.
And then it'll go to creep in a second. It's all fair use because it's under 30 seconds. Each clip, baby.
Law.
Yeah, it was the same song.
I unfortunately didn't grab the clip. Somebody took her vocals and put it over this, and it fits BPM and everything.
Wow.
The key, she's fucked. She's fucked.
And that's her new hit song that she's like the one, the single.
Yeah, because I've heard that. Like top 40 on the radio driving around or whatever. It's just like, what the fuck? I knew I heard it somewhere, but when he said,
wow,
it's the same fucking song.
What's the chorus like?
I think it goes into this. Gone is the bird. Yeah, so it's pretty, it seems pretty damning to me. I know they're both just four chord songs, but still, like, you gotta throw a fucking, you gotta throw a wild card on that third chord.
When she goes higher right there, and shit, it's the same fucking thing.
It's kind of vocal patterns, and it's definitely the guitar. Like,
yeah.
Just because you're not picking every note out of the chord.
But when you can put the vocals right over top of creep and the BPMs and everything match, it's like, come on.
The bass line's different.
So? Yeah. Who cares about the bass?
True.
As a bass player, he said that. Good job, Alan.
I know. Nobody cares.
She is Nutty Queen.
It's a thankless job.
I think she's fucked.
You are Nutty Queen.
I think she's fucked.
Think she's fucked?
Yeah. It's different tones is really the only thing there is.
The tuning's right, and
the bass line is the same, but the tone is so different that
Tom Petty sued the shit out of people for less.
Agreed.
Oh, really? He did?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, dude.
Last year?
Chili Peppers.
Yep.
But you know what that...
Who else? He sued a bunch of people.
So he ran down people's dreams?
Was it Sam Smith?
you know what happened to Tom Petty, though?
I see what you did.
He died.
Yeah.
So, that'll teach you.
Well, yeah, but the lawsuits continue on. They're still going. Because you know they don't settle that shit quick.
No, and it's not Tom Petty. It was Sam Smith, right? Fucking record label. Bullshit.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
I think it was Sam Smith that was the most recent one.
That group that owns fucking Tom Petty shit, that's the one suing Spotify for fucking back pay.
Ooh. Hey, I read something about Spotify too, because last week we talked about that a little bit.
Yeah.
I read something about Apple Music.
The guy that founded Spotify was the original owner of uTorrent.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So he went on from uTorrent to make Spotify.
Wow.
Like, holy
shit. I caught a couple viruses off of uTorrent.
Oh, yeah. uTorrent's fucking dirty. Get rid of it. So that makes a lot of sense, I think. You go from pirating music or pirating whatever, really, to making a monetized Spotify type of thing.
You know what I read about Apple Music?
Would you read
that?
Dave?
It works great.
It's terms of service.
Oh,
oh my god!
Well,
get out of here!
I just agreed.
Oh, god damn it! Did they make you mad?
Well, no. I mean, what makes Dave mad? No, they didn't make me mad. But I did read up on what's going on, and yeah, it's fucked up. Like, Spotify's ripping people off, like artists off, pretty much. I mean, record labels and or whatever, that's trickling down to us, you know.
They're the least paying, if they pay at all.
At all, right?
That's what's
and
fucked.
They're all their employees make a fucking
buttload of money.
Yeah, their pay structures are all wrong.
It's crazy.
It's this week, right? That their IPO. Right?
Yeah.
I think I read, I could be wrong on the number, but I think it was like, if you want to make minimum wage off Spotify, you have to have like 300,000 downloads a month, I think.
Something like ridiculous.
Nobody's getting that.
That's why.
And that's just minimum wage, dude. Yeah. You're not making shit off Spotify.
Portishead has a lawsuit against them, I think.
Yeah, and they have for a while.
Yeah. Because they are one of the most popular bands of that genre at all. And they get crazy downloads. And they got a check for like $2,000.
Fuck,
after
man.
Like a year. So, Apple pays better. It's not great, but...
It's not far off, to be honest.
It's a couple cents more.
Sure, but what their deal is that they actually pay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they'll not they will make good on the smaller amount.
Right.
I made so much money off of Apple and all that.
Yeah, me too. How do you think we got this studio? All this equipment in here for my bands was purchased from income made from Apple Music.
When I cashed in that $12, fucking changed my life.
That got you almost two beers and two shots last night at your shitty bar. That's cool.
I bought a pack of picks off of some Spotify urns.
Oh shit.
A four pack.
Rolling. Got packs for a whole week.
What were you up to this week, Alan?
I didn't do a fucking thing this week.
Just trying to get this fucking
extra
call to Dylan. Fucking
Dylan,
our in the field reporter has caused 8 hours minimum of work
just
on
to
our
get
end.
This shit routed. I'm emailing people. Just plugging in random cables, talking to Matt, listening to him get frustrated. I'm frustrated.
I had to find a place to mount my mic here, dude.
Oh, you poor thing.
Oh, man.
Mounted it to your laptop, which is sketchy as fuck.
Alan was so proud. He hit me up. He called me. He's like, I got it. And then the second I jumped in, he's like, say something. And as a dick, I'm like, something. And then it went, something.
Is there panic if he's hitting? Like hitting escape, closing everything. Like, come on, stop.
It looped back on itself so much, it turned to pure static.
It's just another footnote to put that.
I got it.
I don't know what the fuck I'm doing.
I ripped my
audio equipment.
Without knowing what was going on in my place, I ripped my headset off and it hit Bishop in the face. He's like, what the fuck?
His dog. His fucking poor dog just chilling, his headphones slapping because I'm over here fucking up.
Because it looped so fast, it just became like unbearable.
I know, and I could not escape out of it fast enough. I'm like, what is happening?
Holy shit, Dylan, dude.
We did a lot for you.
But I think
I'm doing a lot for you.
No, you're not. You're just sitting there.
Yeah, you've said like 8 words today.
Sitting there naked, smoking
whiskey. It's really hard to get words in because every time I start talking, you guys can't see me. So you just talk over me. No. I mean, it's not any different than when I'm there. But it's a lot.
You are.
It's a lot harder to get a word in now. So
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm looking right at you.
I said a bunch of things earlier. It's fine. You guys can talk. I'm just a guest today. Just a call-in guest. I'm in the chat.
You're a correspondent. You're not a guest.
I'm in the Discord chat, you know, just hanging out.
Oh, man. Our Discord chat's going up. We gotta get this.
We need to fix this a little more.
A little more, but we're going to get a Discord chat. You can talk to us while we record and stuff.
This is a test run. That was a Discord.
Was it decent for you, though? How was it for you, girl?
What's your experience rating? Would you call into us again?
Maybe. I don't know.
How many dial-ons does our first attempt at getting a Salt Lake correspondent?
11.
Wow.
11 dial-ons?
We did really good then.
Yeah.
I dug through closet space to find random, unique cables.
And
for
I
this.
Sat here and punched my desk until it worked.
I'm just happy to be here.
Sam Ash.
Oh my
$10
God.
At Sam Ash made this 11. Happen.
$11
at Sam Ash.
Oh my God. I don't know how to fix that. I've turned everything off.
I hate.
Is there that little switch on the side of your...
Yeah, it's muted. It's muted.
I hate. Dylan, come back.
Please come back.
See what happened? I get Dylan to work and now I get phone calls from my laptop. Like, stop it.
So,
I sabotaged from before I left last week.
You just set everything up all fucked up.
Is that what you? I believe it too.
He engineered us to fail.
I hate you.
I hacked into your laptop and did stuff.
Are you bragging?
I'm not that smart or have that much time.
Are you bragging about how much you fucked us up?
I'm just happy that you guys need me.
And I'm not bragging. It's just that I didn't believe in Santa Claus at 2.5, and nobody had to tell me. I'm not bragging here, but you know, not everybody's family found it in Texas. Again, I'm not bragging to say that things I've coined become popular parlance. I'm not bragging, but aren't those some big pecs? Not bragging wins religious polls. I knew Vladimir Putin listened on a routine basis.
Fuck.
That's not bragging.
I'm not bragging. I really have read thousands of books.
I know what I'm talking about. I'm not some pseudo-intellectual here. I'm not bragging. And I'm not bragging. I mean, it's a fact, folks. I can think 50 bragging. Levels up, okay?
And I'm not bragging saying I'm Mr. Cool. The only reason I've always been the coolest guy around.
When I was 12, I'm not bragging. This is normal behavior.
Alex Jones, coolest guy around.
But I was 14 dating college chicks. I'm not bragging. I can't help it. I start just saying, here's $50 bills. You ladies all have whatever you want. This is big, big, big mojo. Okay. I mean, I'm not bragging. I just want you to get the newsflash here. I am the person that popularized the term false flag. The truth is, I'm extremely vicious. Yeah, I'm not bragging. A lot of men are like that. I'm crazy.
He's turning into Rush Limbaugh.
He is. Well, Rush is on his way out. Vicious. We need a new one.
The problem is, I don't want to release this stuff on the earth, and I'm not bragging. I'm like a gorilla. I'm not bragging. I mean, I'm a machine if I get in a fight. I'm not bragging. I'm not bragging, but I would literally have just absolutely devastated all those people in about 10 seconds. If I was to hit somebody 20 times, they'd probably die. I can punch pretty hard, not bragging.
I can punch pretty hard, I'm not bragging.
But I got in fights in high school. Punch me, I punch you back. And then I slam your head in the concrete. I'm not bragging, but I'm not bragging. Super Texas hillbilly, you name it. Man, basically killers. I'm very proud.
Texas hillbilly. Did you hear about Charlie Daniels this week?
Oh, what do you do now?
Oh, that's the devil went guy. Down to
yeah,
Georgia.
Yeah, devil went down to Georgia guy. He's an idiot.
Dave, I'm going to throw three words together. Charlie Daniels, Taco Bell, Illuminati.
Oh, my God. This sounds amazing.
It's like if like a newsroom was bored and we're pulling names and shit out of a hat.
Right,
they go,
right.
All right, what's the first one? Charlie Daniels. All right. We can work with that. He's 81, but we'll work with it.
And where was
what's
he?
What's your next one?
Where was he?
What's your next one?
He was at Taco Bell. Yeah. Okay. Charlie Daniels at Taco Bell.
Now, what's the third one? What do you got?
Who was he with?
Illuminati.
The Illuminati. So Charlie Daniels was at Taco Bell on 35th Avenue with the Illuminati.
All these buzzwords are on a fucking dartboard.
It's like South Park's Family Guy episode generator. Did you see that with the manatees and everything? Uh-huh. Yeah, that's,
look at this headline. So Charlie Daniels warns Taco Bell, the Illuminati is not a frivolous subject.
What the fuck? This is a Fox News headline, you guys.
The devil went down to Georgia.
You better watch out.
Have you read some of the things that he's said or listened? Like, he's
crazy.
He's a racist son of a bitch, first of all.
I've heard his songs at pool halls and all sick monic shows.
Oh, yeah.
But right here's his tweet. Hey, Taco Bell, the Illuminati is not a frivolous subject.
Taco Bell tweeted.
Bell, they have new commercials.
Oh, new commercials.
Bell Illuminati.
Yeah. Bell Illuminati.
Okay, I was going to say.
At Taco Bell, the dollar gets you access to more.
Ooh.
Like the new $1 stacker with lavish layers of seasoned beef and melty cheese. But how can all these layers only cost a dollar? Something's not stacking up. Is the $1 stacker reserved for a secret society or just anyone with a dollar?
Oh my God.
The answer is yes.
I love Taco Bell.
Play the other one.
The
other one like does math and shit. Go up. Yeah, this one is great.
It's Bell Illuminati, dude.
The Illuminati.
There's a powerful connection between the dollar and Taco Bell.
Yeah. TB.
Because it unlocks a world of 20 decadent menu items from breakfast to late night for just a dollar each.
All the
20 items for a dollar. 20 steps on the pyramid. Who's really behind this? Is it the Illuminati or the Bell-Illuminati? Experience the power of the dollar at Taco Bell.
They fold the,
dollar
till it says taco.
Holy shit. Did Dan Brown direct that commercial?
Who is the Dan Brown?
You never heard of Dan Brown?
Is he the queen?
Is he the queen?
Never going away.
Fuck.
No, it'll be gone by next month. That's this month. What's next month?
I don't know.
Oh, we'll find the next. The thing is about that meme.
Look at that. Oh, my God.
It's seven memes combined into the
best. I know. That's pretty interesting. Well, that's kind of like that's got the same feel as Brad's wife from last year. Brad's wife working at Cracker Barrel.
What are you talking about?
You never heard that meme?
Service. No. You never saw Brad's wife? There was a Facebook page that had like 1.1 million followers.
Type in Brad's wife.
Yeah, Brad's wife.
Cracker Barrel.
Cracker Barrel. Yeah, I can't believe you didn't see that one.
There
that was funny, actually. Like,
You laughed at the other one. Fuck
I did.
You.
I'm not saying it wasn't. I didn't mean it like that.
Your highbrow ass.
There was.
Dave talks about some really good charity work he's doing or whatever, and thinks he's better than all of us.
Yeah. Cool, bro.
Well, I kind of am.
Yeah. Why? It's really weird in Dave's contract that he demanded his chair be 6 inches taller than our chairs.
Yeah.
Is that like, all right, you guys?
What's up with that? He's lording over us. Right? I hate it.
You signed it, like, I mean,
I know we signed it, but I didn't really understand it at the time, and now I'm just sitting
yeah,
here
was
like
actually physically 6 inches taller. Yeah.
His dick's bigger, he's taller than me.
I know you guys seriously give me a lot of love on this show. Like, I'm just saying
the giantest
11
of...
years of service.
11 years, wait. What am I looking for? I don't...
Well, this is it. Like,
I mean, check. All right, here's the synopsis of Brad's wife at Cracker Barrel. There was never a Brad. There was never a Brad's wife. But people were going around commenting on Cracker Barrel's Twitter and shit going, I can't believe you fired Brad's wife after 11 years of service.
Because some one guy
Cracker
made,
Barrel's like, what the fuck? Yeah, like,
one guy totally post-lawed a comment. And like, you know, like, I mean, but it caught on. It was hilarious. Like, I remember reading the original thread, like in screenshots or whatever. And it was really fucking funny. It was, it's, you know, typical liberal ripping up a conservative or whatever. And it spawned into a Facebook page that had like a million followers. No,
even to this day, on like a news story that has nothing to do with it, they'll be like, I can't believe we need justice for Brad's wife. Fired after 11 years of service.
11 years of hard service.
Totally unrelated shit, too.
Yeah, yeah. Justice Internet for Brad's wife.
Is so fucking dumb, and I love all of it.
Brad's wife.
Did you see it was National Roast Day, and fucking people started hitting up Wendy's, which is the most savage of Twitters?
There was a National Roast Day, and I missed it?
Check it out. Wendy's kills it on this stuff. At Wendy's, can you find me the nearest McDonald's? They posted a picture of a trash can. Guy deletes his Twitter account after Wendy's roast.
Oh, my God.
Your beef is frozen, and we all know it. Y'all know we laugh at your slogan, fresh, never frozen, right? Like you're really a joke. So you deliver it on a raw and hot truck. Where do you think cold things are stored that aren't frozen?
Fuck.
Y'all should give up at McDonald's. Got you guys beat with them dope-ass breakfast. Yeah. You don't have to bring them into this just because you forgot how refrigerators existed
for a second there. Yeah.
God damn it.
That's good stuff.
Yeah, they fucking killed it, this whole fucking thread.
Wendy's is always hot.
Hot.
I don't know when it was cool to just like hire a dude to be a dick on the internet for your company, but like
I wish works. I could get that job.
Where do you apply?
I'm good at it. I'm good at it, you guys.
Who would you work for?
That's davidcbernier@gmail.com. Arby's is fucking amazing.
Nobody can spell your last name.
I know, right?
I thought you'd have that super elite fucking spelling.
Well, I've got Blackbeard@gmail.com.
With all numbers.
Is it the actual Wendy's Twitter, or is it just like...
It's actually Wendy's.
Yeah.
They hired somebody to be a dick to people.
The other good Twitter is the last Blockbuster.
So
there's actually quite a few of them still alive.
So check it out. Burger King just tweeted randomly, $5 for $4 because 5 is better than 4. And then some guy's like, at Wendy's, what are you firing back? They at that person, edible food. They just straight shit on other people in public.
My friends want to go to McDonald's. What should I tell them? Find new friends. Oh, man.
Put your hat around. You aren't Bart Simpson. That's what Wendy's said.
Waiting for the Wendy's roast to happen to me. Turn that hat around. You aren't Bart Simpson. This isn't 1997. So awesome. It's all good. You guys should Google it. It's fucking good, but...
Yeah, right. Wendy's Twitter.
All I got on that.
Don't take my word for it. Google it.
I have the documents. The black helicopter. I'm not bragging, but I'm
the new Rush Limbaugh.
And I'm not bragging.
So
sorry, I ate a big bowl of chili before the episode.
I can't believe I ate like a pig. That's why I blew my load in 8 seconds.
I'm pretty the Hulk Hogan thing might sue us into oblivion.
He might sue us. Sorry,
Hulk Hogan.
Hey, I want a lawsuit too.
No.
I'll sue the fuck out of you, Dave.
Yeah,
Dave.
Can we all just sue each other?
Dave doesn't work here, but he works here. I'm not him.
Dave is not of my employ. Just legally speaking.
So
fucking dicks.
I think that's about it.
People can follow us.
Oh, no, no. One more thing.
Yeah, Dylan's got it.
What?
Follow us on Twitter, man.
Yeah.
We'll roast you.
Oh, straight up. I've got some good ones, guys.
Oh, really?
Come at me.
Old actually, man. Just come shit on Dave on our Twitter.
Yeah, that'd be even better.
Please send us hate mail or corrections to nfhcpodcast@gmail.com.
We like it.
nfhcpodcast at Twitter.
Facebook.com.
Roast us there. Roast us. Who gives a shit?
NFHC podcast.
Give me that fire.
Give us all of the fire.
Make it funny, though. Like, no, I mean, if it's not funny.
People
like,
aren't funny. People aren't
if it's
funny.
Not funny, we're reading it, then making fun of you.
Yeah.
You better come in there.
So either way.
Bring heat, because I'm weekly trying to test Dave's thick skin.
Who are we playing? Who are we playing this week?
Yeah, Dylan, we got the Holy Fawn approval, yeah?
Holy Fawn.
We do have the Holy Fawn approval.
We're going to end this episode with one of our favorite bands, not just because they're fucking local. They're a great
band.
I don't even know them. Dylan knows them.
Well, I've seen them live a couple of times. Yeah, great.
I dig it.
You came with me a couple of times, too. Yeah.
We go to their shows on purpose.
I don't know them. We discovered that one, that other band watching Holy Fawn. What was that band? The fucking Motherships or Mother?
Oh,
Mother Tapes. That band.
Portland,
cool.
Yeah.
I think so.
Yeah. I bought their record.
Dave was in love because that guy was looping pedals into software MacBook looping.
Whoa.
Yeah, he was doing it all via DAW. Like,
next level looping, dude.
They didn't have a bass player. Yeah. He had
a bass physically hard mounted to a table with like a laptop and
into an interface
like an Akai MPC 30 or whatever fuck? Like pad like and he had all kinds of stuff on the
so
table.
He'd record the bass line for the song in real time in Ableton and Ableton has little
Live,
buttons
yeah.
to where you can like go to the next section yeah. that you recorded.
But he had it hooked up to a foot pedal.
Yeah, instead of recording running a sequence.
Hey, I got an idea. Why don't you just get a fucking bass player? Sounds a lot easier.
Because sometimes you can't.
They were two people on tour doing
People on tour doing the shit fuck and killing
what's wrong
it?
With a third?
You make Nothing. More money.
Yeah, well, there's that too.
Oh.
And they can say that they did it
all. And on top
live.
Of it, like, I mean, we are all very tolerant people. We put up with you.
Yeah, I'm more put up with rather than accepted. All right.
Well, it's your show.
Yeah, thank you.
Oh, yeah, his show. He's put so much work into it.
All of the work. Hand-picked.
How much work do you put into it?
Well, I do gotta say, Dylan was missed today.
Yeah, we missed Dylan.
I totally miss you, Dylan. Like,
there's a wet spot where his chair would be because I just kept pouring my beers out where it was.
Watch out for the hospital.
I'm not dead. Shit.
You're in Utah. There. You're fucking close.
Mormons are dangerous people.
So anyway, thanks for listening. Here's Holy Fawn. We love them. Bye.
Later, guys.
Boom.
Hold on. Wait.
What?
Oh, bitch. You got jacked, bitch.
Oh, my God. All right, guys. We'll see you next week.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.